Good evening and welcome to this, the third concert in our series Live in Your Lounge. Tonight's concert is an entirely Italian affair featuring composers Puccini, Verdi and Respighi. We're going to open the concert with one of Puccini's works for string quartet. He didn't write very much, that wasn't for the operatic stage, but this is one of the little gems that exists. It's called Il Crisantimi, and it was written in a single night in 1890 in response to the death of a friend. Puccini then went on to use some of the themes of this piece, or two themes, in his last opera, Manon Lescaut, in 1893. It's a beautiful continuous movement, and I hope you enjoy it. Then Maura will introduce the arias that she's going to sing after that. So sit back and relax and enjoy the concert.
Thank you. When programming some arias to link us through from the Puccini Quartet to the Respighi, initially we thought of Puccini himself and his amazing operas. So we went to La Bohème and the story of Mimi and Rodolfo. We follow their love story quite quickly through her two arias, the first in Act One, where she has just met Rodolfo and he has told her all about his wonderful life as a bohemian and a poet and asks her to tell him about her life, and she does, her simple life as she sees it, as sowing flowers. But she's quite poetic herself, and in the way that she speaks and talks about how looking over the Paris rooftops, that first April sunlight seems like her first kiss each year. We then move through to not such a happy point in their relationship in Act Three, when she has overheard Rodolfo telling Marcello about how she has consumption and is dying and he isn't able to take it. He's not able to be with her and go through that so up close and personal. She overhears and realizes that since he's not really strong enough to leave her, that she will leave him. So Donde Lieta is actually a song of breaking up, but with great soul to it. She says, I will leave you without any bad feeling. We then move on to Verdi and La Traviata Violetta. The link here between choosing to go to Verdi was actually to do with what's coming up with the Respighi, and you'll hear about how Shelley wrote it after a bout of consumption. So we went through to two consumptive ladies, both Mimi and Violetta. This is Violetta's final aria when she is alone, apart from her maid, and is longing to see Alfredo, her love, again, and she feels weak. The color has gone from her cheeks, and she realizes that it is now all gone.
Mi chiamano, oh, We now move on to the first of two works by Ottorino Respighi that you'll hear in this concert. And this is his lovely nocturne for solo piano. Respighi was an Italian composer and violinist, and he was best known for large orchestral works such as The Fountains of Rome or The Pines of Rome. Less well known are his solo piano pieces, and he didn't write a huge amount for that genre. But this happens to be one of my favourite piano works to play. As with all nocturnes, it depicts a night scene, and for me this really conjures up images of the moon shining on a lake, and you can hear in the writing, the piano writing, this lovely sort of shimmering effect beneath a gorgeous melody that's soaring above. So I hope you enjoy Respighi's Nocturne for solo piano. Thank you.
Respighi wrote this quartet based on a translation of a Shelley poem, The Sunset. It's a beautiful poem, and Shelley wrote it when he himself had experienced consumption for the first time and actually had lost his first child in the same year. So he was faced with a huge battle with his own, facing his own mortality. The poem talks about a young couple, a man and a woman, who meet, and they're clearly just gotten together, as it talks about the woman first knowing the mingling that comes together when two people come together. And they have a beautiful pastoral scene set for them with the woods, and the moon is coming out, and the sun has just gone beneath the horizon, but there are shimmers of the light along the clouds. And the man says to the woman, "Oh, Isabella, isn't it funny that, you know, I haven't seen the sun here? Tomorrow we'll come together and we will see the sun together." And then she wakes up in the morning and her lover is dead. It then talks about how she doesn't get to die. She doesn't die, she doesn't go mad. She's left to walk the earth and care for her elderly father. And she isn't really living anymore. They talk about how she is dead inside, really, and how her eyelashes are filled and clogged with the tears that never seem to fall. It's a beautiful, beautiful setting, and Shelley apparently was in huge fear of leaving his partner Mary, leaving her to live her life without him. So, the Respighi Quartet, Il Tramonto.
Thank you.
Thank you for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed the concert. Our Live in Your Lounge series will continue a little later on in the year. In the meantime, we are currently preparing a series of short videos featuring performances and interviews with the principal artists of the Fuse Ensemble, plus some invited guests. Details of these will be announced in due course. For now, from all of us at Newry Chamber Music, we wish you well, stay safe, and we look forward to reconnecting with you very soon.